Okay, so continuing on with our fixed blade review, I'm going to move over to the K-bar everybody's familiar with. I wish I had a better camera so you could see better detail on this, but hey, cameras are expensive. All right, so this is a mini K-bar. How many of you out there were looking at it going, that's a little small? Yeah, probably nobody, because you don't notice anything. But you have to. You always got to notice everything. So these little mini K-bars, they came out some years back. I really like these things. I mean, I've taken these with me on security details. I've taken them with me quite a few places. And I actually use them to teach blocks of the security training when I hold seminars and stuff. I really like these a lot because, see, the bigger something is, like let's say this Kufri thing, this is really easy to get your hands on, and there's a lot of leverage. You could really, if you could stop this, you could take this away fairly easily if you know what you're doing. Now we get to the battle of, is bigger better? Well, I mean, depends who you ask, right? But when it gets into pocket knives, I say, yeah, you don't really want to go smaller than these things. But when you get into a fixed blade, I don't think you want to go too big if you're going to use it as a battle knife. Now, I'm not talking out on a battlefield, soldiers. I'm talking in your civilian life, maybe you go in camp and you want a nice utility knife. Now, you guys, it's probably some of you that are going to argue and tell me that there's nothing better than a full-size K-bar, battle-proven. Absolutely. I'm not going to argue with that. It's got a good Rockwell strength. Look, good enough for a Marine, good enough for me. But for my personal use and taste, it's just too big. It's just way too big. Now, I'll tell you what. Some of the bodyguards that have recently come down, because when it's nice weather, you know, they like to come down here. But I've told them, I said, you know, this case is too cumbersome. You can't hide this. Here's the nice thing about these mini K-bars. The big ones are so big, really, it's very hard to hide them. But I teach them techniques on how to take a knife this size and carry it very safely without the scabbard. And that's something I'm not going to get into. I think it's a moral issue that you really got to watch what you're putting on this YouTube. Too many people are out there looking for the wrong type of knowledge for the wrong type of reason. So when I train professionals, they are actively engaged in those arenas that they use that training. I don't just teach this, you know, freely. So I just always want to make that point. Since this is a new series of videos, points I want to beat that I just know that my students take for granted. But I'm very, very conservative with who gets what. Because it's good stuff. Hey, look, everybody can have gum, right? Because what's it going to do to you? Everybody can have an Alka-Seltzer, because can you really OD on it because you have too much? But, you know, we don't go to the Chiclets aisle and start pulling prescription drugs. Why? Because those prescription drugs could kill you. It's dangerous. So I look at my techniques kind of like the prescription. You know, it's the right prescription for some, and it's wrong for others. And, you know, you don't just hand out narcotics to people that want to feel good. So maybe you think that's a little bit arrogant of a statement, but I do think it's a moral issue. I mean, look, if you're walking around telling people that 5 pounds of pressure is going to break your knee, you know, really, who gives a shit who knows that? Because it's bullshit. I mean, the only moral issue there is you might get somebody killed because they're going to honestly believe it, much like when I was a kid and even into my adult life. Hey, Sensei said this would work, so I'm going to try it. You know, next thing you know, you're all bloody, you can't see, and, you know, hoping that you got a couple of teeth left in your mouth. So it's the same thing with techniques. But anyway, back to this. See, now you military guys, my guys, you guys got some big honking knives, and you guys are using those probably. You're probably digging in the dirt with them. One of my guys, I'm so proud, he went on to be a Navy SEAL. Another one's flying attack helicopters. Another one's doing recon in the choppers. Got another one that's an airborne ranger. Now look, these are specialized guys. So what they do with that knife in their duty life is far different than what we do as civilians. I mean, but like I say, you know, you really want to learn what to do, I think we've got to look at the executive protection racket, and those are the kind of things that, you know, I think are good for civilians, if you do it the right way. Anyway, I teach those guys how to take a knife this size and safely carry it, and in the training block, we do rolls, break falls, a little bit of small grappling, and I teach them how to conceal this on certain parts of their body according to how they are made up, what their physical features are, and what their particular duties will be, and how to keep a knife this size on you and safely carry it without the scabbard. Because look, I can't put this thing up my sleeve here. Come on, get in there. Look, it's so damn big. And walk around. Okay, that didn't work out, but you get what I'm saying. I can't walk around like Fonzie with the cigarette pack here. So you can't really put these things in too many places. They're going to be seen. So you're much better off taking one of these little minis, throwing the scabbard in your suitcase or something, I guess if you're working in detail. But, you know, for self-defense, you got to keep something in the nightstand or in your car, check your local laws, some places you can't carry a fixed blade. I really like these. This thing's got this rubber handle on it. Even if it gets bloody, slippery, sticky, you're staying on it. This little guard, that ain't going to stop anything from hurting you, but it does let you know where your blade is. You're not going to get in trouble touching the back of the blade. You know, typical K-bar design, it's not sharp back there. And, you know, I wouldn't use this for opening your tuna cans or anything. But if you leave them sharp and you don't screw with them, it's plenty sharp. And the way that they're made, the Rockwell strength, the design of the steel, you know, this is a pretty strong little knife, full tang construction. You got the back of it. I mean, it's a K-bar. It's everything that a K-bar is. It's just a mini model. And it's a cool knife. So I would say, if you're looking for a fixed blade that you want to maybe carry if you can, you know, scrap the holster, find a way to put this somewhere or make a holster for it. But this is a good length. It's a good length because it doesn't stick out too far. And if you reverse grip it, it's easy to tuck in. Now let's not get into technique, he's holding it wrong and all that, because, you know, like anything that you do enough, there's the way you teach it. There's a way that you learn it, and then you make it yours. And when you make it your own, it doesn't mean that it's wrong if it works for you. It's only wrong if it doesn't work. So let's not get into technical stuff. But, you know, these are easy to hold. If you don't want somebody to see it, it blends in really nice. You don't want something sticking out here. You know, something that people don't practice is switching grips. Can you take it from here and manipulate it and flip it back up easy? You know, a lot of people, they do this and then they go, okay, well, put it back to the first position, and they go, okay, well, now the blade's the wrong way. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, you got to be able to flip it down and rotate it, flip it up and rotate it. That was a little sloppy because it's slow. You really need that momentum. But my point is, you got to be comfortable with the knife, and this thing's just a little oval, so you should be able to be comfortable with this thing. You got to transition in a fight. Look, you may have to switch hands. So you really got to be able to hold on to your weapon. You really got to be able to really hold on to that thing tight if it's getting taken away from you. You don't want too big of a handle, too small of a handle. You know, hey, look, good enough for the military, good enough for me, okay? Put a little saddle soap on your scabbard here, because they're pretty damn stiff, and you know, sometimes stiff is good, but you don't want to walk around with a stiffy all night. A little bit of saddle salt, mink oil, soften that right up. Okay, here's probably my favorite, and I gotta say, it's pretty useless. I don't carry it. I bought this, there was a student that I had, and we were real close at the time, and I wanted to have the same knife. I thought that'd be cool. A lot of times, a student that's special to me, you know, I'll say, like, here, we'll both get this. And we never ended up training with them or anything. And what I call the path, this is for you over there in Afghanistan. I keep telling you, when you come back, if you want to train, you should train on the path. That's That's the high training. But it takes a lot of study and dedication. And for personal reasons, he just didn't have the time. And we never did get to train with these. But this is a really, really cool knife. And actually, I haven't had this thing out in years. Probably 7 years. And I'm just looking at it while I'm talking. I see this thing moving. Now, I was just about to brag about SOG. But SOG broke. Look at this piece of shit. This plastic thing that, you know, I thought this was really cool because they give you this little disconnector. You can just pull this thing out, put it over your belt, and slam it back in. And there's a screw. There's two Phillips head screws, and there's holes here, so you can take this out and put it here, so you can carry it sideways. Well, I'm just looking at the stupid thing, and it's broken. Look at this piece of shit. Huh. I wonder if they'll send me another one, but they'll probably want shipping. So, I don't know what I'm going to do with this. Wow. Huh. Okay, well anyway, I think it's a pretty good knife anyway. Maybe when I pull it out, the blade's all gone. I put it away with a lot of oil on it. This is a full tang, nice heavy pommel on it. They actually give you these little inserts. There's three inserts here and three over here. At least the blade's not rusted. So this is a double-edged dagger. It has one side of serration on it. You know, daggers are a world of their own to fight with. And again, you know, this is more of a stabber than a cutter. But this is more suited to a water environment. Maybe my Navy SEAL guy would think that this is just, you know, the cat's ass. This would just be the greatest because of what he's trained and, you know, what he's used to. It's a great knife. I mean, it's got these little supports here. It's easy to flip around. And it's double-edged. I mean, what more do you want? Except, possibly, a scabbard that doesn't break. I mean, imagine walking down the street with this piece of shit, and the thing falls off, and, you know, your knife's falling on the street. Wow. I didn't even notice that until now. So, I guess I'll have to call SOG and see if they'll send me one. Wholesale, damn thing was close to $100. Anyway, here again, this thing's huge. I mean, how would you conceal something like this? So, I still go back to conservative. You want to use something that is concealable. Even if you're going to be walking around out in the woods with it. Look, you don't want to fall down and break a rib because, you know, the pommel sticks you. So, I wouldn't get too concerned with flash. It's about utility and it's about comfort. And look, you got to work out. If you're not doing those curls, you're not doing those triceps, you're not going to have any strength in your hands. How are you going to flip that knife around? You got to work your shoulders. Shoulders. There's a lot of shoulder in a knife fight. If you guys ain't hitting the gym and don't carry a knife, get a little egg roll poker. You'll look very cool.